Today our topic is introduction to web server. What is the main function of web server? This web server main function of web server is the main function of web server is to this web server is store web pages and process the web pages, and it is delivered to client. Who wants that web pages? It is providing that web page to the client. And here, for example, this is client. And for example, this is internet, and this is our web server. Now here.
Hello, sir. Sorry for interruption, sir.
Hello.
Mute all the students, please mute class. Sorry, sir. Someone is playing some video. Please mute all the one.
Please all of you mute your mics.
Hey, कौन है जिसका फोटो इस पे आ रहा है?
Mr. Tulsidas, please
mute your mics. This PC means client PC connected to internet, and this internet connected to this web server. Now this client wants some web pages.
Angad.
That time. Which protocol communicating this client to server? This client to server communication
purpose.
बोल की
बोलना कदर है तेरा
मुन्ने कहीं बोल
ये ना लेगा बस
All students are now muted from my side. You can take class now.
Now, this PC means this client wants some web pages. So that time, how to communicate this client to this server? For communication from this client to web server, that purpose here we are using HTTP protocol, hypertext transfer protocol. This protocol is works in application layer, and this HTTP purpose assigning port number is EID. Now, if client want to access some website files or some web files, so that time this PC send request to this internet. Next here, now this request is sent by using HTTP or URL. So now this web server is receiving that request, and it is send that data from here to client. That purpose here means here it is sent that web pages in hypertext markup language in this mode. Means here this web pages is transferring in HTML hypertext markup language. In this mode, they are sending that web pages. Now, in your PC, browser is rendering that HTML page and it is giving in multimedia mode, graphics mode. Actually, HTML pages is different. If you are watching HTML pages, that time it is different. It's totally is look like a program coding type. When your browser is rendering that HTML page, that time we are seeing that web page with graphics mode. Means here we are seeing header and here we are seeing pictures. Here we are seeing content. Means animation mode, graphics mode. And here. Means here, this is a simple idea about how to work web server. Means here, client, web server. Now, client want to access some web pages. That time, this PC connected to internet and this internet connected to this web server. Now, this client is send one request. So here, communication between this client PC and this web server PC, in this communication purpose, we are using HTTP protocol. This HTTP protocol is communicating between this web server and your client PC. Now, this web server PC is sending that web content, means web pages in HTML format. Now, in your PC internal, that browser is rendering that HTML page and it is showing in graphics mode. Okay. HTTPS Hypertext Transfer Protocol. And another one is Hypertext Markup Language, HTML. Now, this web page means HTML page in this have this HTML page have pictures and content text and another one is we are using another
yes it is audible and visible clearly
text we are using another one. Means here in HTML page we are using pictures text. So on here this purpose we are using some under different language. Means here graphics purpose. Means here now this HTML page have pictures text and content. Means like what is it? In this also including another one font means not font okay. Here this one pictures and text. Now we are creating HTML page and in this we are using pictures and text and that purpose we are using another languages. And we are discussing what are the block changes, which purpose we are using, we are discussing after some time. And here, now, this is a web server and this is a PC. Now we are uploading web pages. That purpose we are using mainly four methods. In this, first one is shared posting, and the second one is virtual private server posting, and another one is dedicated hosting. Fourth one, please. Cloud hosting. Means, for example, now I want to upload my website. So that time I am selecting in this for anyone. First one is the shared hosting. Another one is the virtual private server hosting. Another one is the dedicated hosting. Another one is the cloud hosting. What are the difference between shared, VPS, dedicated, cloud? Now we are discussing. First one is shared hosting. Shared hosting means, for example, I am creating some web pages. That pages belongs to my company. My company is a one small company, and that web pages is more than 10 or 15 web pages. So now I want to create my website and uploading that in that server. So that I am here I have four options. Which option is suitable for me? Means here I want to create my website, but in low cost. So that time I am giving preferred shared hosting. Why? Means here this is physically one server. So this is web server. Web server. In shared hosting, one physical web server, it is host hundreds of different domains. That is the main feature of this shared hosting. Means why we are saying main feature? Means, for example, I am starting one small company. I want to create my website and I am uploading my website with low cost. So that I am selecting shared hosting. In this, they are using one server. This server is capable to host hundreds of different domains and different clients. So here, simple example means, here I am sharing my room. Study purpose, I am going outside city, that I am taking one room for rent purpose. So that time I am share my room with colleagues. So that time this room maintenance cost is reducing. Same way here, I am share this server with another different clients. So that time this server maintenance cost is very less. Means my website rental cost is very less. Means here, this server maintenance cost and total they are shared. For example, here they are shared 1,000 users to this server. Then this 1,000 users sharing that this server maintenance cost. So that time I am receiving minimal cost from this server. Means if I want create one website, First, I am registered my website in one domain. That purpose I am paying some money to that domain. Means they are charging per year some amount. That amount is depending on my web pages content. For example, I am creating 10 pages only, web pages. But in this 10 pages, I am using HD photos. Means HD photo means it is occupying more data. So in this 10 pages, I am using 10 HD photos. That time it is occupying more space. So that time this service provider is charging more money. So here, now I am registered my domain, and after I am uploading my website in this server, that time they charged money depending on my web file, how much space I'm paying, web file size, how much my web files is, what is the size of my web files, and how, which type of features you want. So depending on my web file size and depending on my features, this provider is charging some money. So in this shared hosting, minimum cost nowadays, if I want to upload my website, that purpose they are charging minimum 2000 rupees. Depending on your web file size and depending on your features. So here, this server means this service provider charging 2000 to up to 1 lakh or 1.5 lakh or more than, depending on the features. Means if you want more space and more bandwidth, the time the service provider is charged more money. But here you want to reduce your cost about this website. So that time you are selecting shared hosting. In this shared hosting, you are uploading small size of web files. For example, you are uploading, 300 MB or 500 MB or 600 MB. So depending on that, your website size, they are charged money. So this is the advantage. Means if your website or your web files are very small size, that time always you prefer shared hosting. Means this your website web files is very small size, that time they are accessing easily from this shared hosting. But in this shared hosting, drawback is, for example, your website is getting more hits and your website files is more, means the website file size is more. That time you don't select this shared hosting. Drawback is here, other clients also sharing this server. So depending on the other client's website web files, your web accessing speed is depending. So if other also using some more size files, means that website files is more size, that time your website is accessing slowly. That is another in this drawback. This is the main drawback of this shared hosting. Means if your website have less size of files, that time you give preference to shared hosting. If your website is receiving more hits and your website file size is more, that time you don't select shared hosting. But in this main advantage, means if your website is small size, then you give shared hosting means one server shared hundreds of clients, and this server is capable to providing service to different domains. And here another advantage, for example, one client. This client is maintaining three websites. For example, here one client personally is maintaining personal website. Another, this person is more interested in music. That purpose, he is maintaining one music blogspot. Music blog. And this person also maintaining company website. So that time this person is registered these three websites in three domains depending related to this content. After this three websites upload in single in that server in shared hosting, means they are using only this user account and they are uploading these three different websites in this shared hosting. This is also one advantage of this shared hosting. Another one is, for example, if you are selecting shared hosting, many service providers is providing access control panel. Access control panel. Generally, if we want to create one website related to our office or related to our shop or related to our company, that time we are assigning this work to one web developer. So that time that web developer is designing website depending on our choice. Means we are giving some preferences. So depending on our taste, they are creating one website. After we are paying some money to the domain and we are registering and we are buying the domain, and after we are uploading this web files to in this shared hosting, after maintenance, for example, I am uploading my website. That website is related to my shop. If any festival is coming, that time my shop is providing some discounts on some items. So that time I am informing this information to consumers by using my website. So that time if I want to change my website or I want to upload this content to this website, generally we are consulted to that website developer. So every time we are consult to website developer is not possible. If you are consult every time, they are charging something more. But in this shared hosting, its advantage is access control panel. Means this shared hosting service provider is giving access control panel. So that time, this access control panel purpose, they are creating one software. So by using that software, we are access our website, we are modifying our website without web developer help. So if I want to update latest photos, if I want to update some text, so by using that software, we are updating our website by using access control panel. This is the main advantage of this shared hosting. And in this another option is, this is professionally maintained. professionally maintained means, for example, now I am hosting my website in this server. For example, any problem in this server, it is related to hardware or software. This total headache related to that service provider means I am paying for per month some rental to this service provider. If any issue is rising in this server, either hardware or software side, that service provider is solving that issues. Means this server is maintaining service provider. So if any problem is coming, that is service provider headache. It is not related to our headache. This is also one main advantage of this shared hosting. Means every month we are paying some money and remaining all things is maintaining by service provider. Any hardware issue or any software issue, that issue is solved by service provider. Another one is virtual private server hosting. Previously we are discussing means, for example, previously what is that shared hosting? Shared hosting nothing but I am share my room with my colleagues. Means in this we are staying 4 or 5 people. This 5 people is sharing this total room maintenance cost. Means room rent, electricity, and food, everything sharing these 4 people. This is called shared hosting. So in this shared hosting, drawback is if under clients means your web performance, this your web access performance depending on other clients website, their website also. So this is the drawback. And another one is the virtual private server hosting. Means in this virtually we are creating one server, and in this we are hosting our web files. Means, for example, simple understanding purpose, one example here. For example, we are staying in one apartment. This is our plot. For example, this is 407. Plot number is 407. This is our plot. Means in this only you are staying in this plot. So here, this is your plot. You are the only you are living in this plot. Others is cannot disturb you. Means here only one you are staying here. So others cannot disturbing you. But your plot also part of this building. Means in this apartment have many plots. In these plots you are taking one plot rental basis. Means here one server, in this server you are taking some space in rental basis. But so means that space, that memory, that processor, others cannot take in. Means others cannot access your virtual server. So that time your web performance is more compared to shared hosting. Means here, for example, this is the server. In this server, you want to create virtual private server. So that time they are asking, what is the your requirement? That time you are saying, I want 2 GB RAM, and I want a dual core processor, and I want, for example, 50 GB or 100 GB space. Means here, this is a very large, very big size server. In this server, now you are hosting your web pages. If you are hosting your web pages in previous method, so that time your web performance is reducing. So if you want your web performance, that purpose you are selecting virtual private server. So now here This is one service provider. This service provider is maintaining very big server. In this big server, you are hiring, means you are taking rent some part virtually, but creating one server. In this server, means your server configuration is 2 GB RAM and dual core processor and 512 GB space. So you are taking, you are hiring, you are hiring this space and this processor speed and this RAM. So now, what is the your requirement? Depending on your requirement, this service provider charging some money. Compared to shared hosting, VPS hosting is costly. Compared to shared hosting, means here they are specially reserved some space, some RAM, some processor for your web page purpose. So that time your web performance is good. Some compared to shared hosting, but this is costly compared to shared hosting. This is called virtual private server hosting. Means this service provider is maintaining very big server. In this server, I am hiring some area. Means they are creating virtually one server. In this server, they are uploading my web pages or website, and now clients accessing my website without delay, without interruptions. So that time my website performance is good. So that time my business is increasing. This is one method. Another one is dedicated server. Dedicated server means here one server specially allocating to your website. Means this total this server specially for your website purpose. So compared to this others, means shared hosting and virtual private server hosting, in this performance is very good, but cost is more expensive. Means here you are purchasing this server, and you are purchasing this server operating system, you are purchasing that application software, after you are hosting your website in this server, after you are maintaining this website. So that time, this is very cost effective, and it is very costly process, dedicated server. So general normal small business persons don't select this dedicated server. Means here this server is very costly compared to others. Dedicated server, why it is costly? Means here maintaining one own server, this server only specially for our website purpose. So that purpose, we are maintaining this server, and we are purchasing this server, and we are purchasing this server operating system, we are purchasing this server application software. So that time it is very costly. But here main advantage is performance is very high compared to others. Means only this server is pro, have only your website files. If any person is trying to access your website, immediately it is providing that data to that client. And another one means here, how do we understand this dedicated server? Means previously, what is that? First one is shared. So shared server means I am giving one example. You are sharing one room with your colleagues. Means all persons sharing one single room. Another one is virtual private server. In this, you are hiding some space in one server. Means you are taking one plot in apartment. So apartment have is very big size. In this big size, you are hiring one plot. Virtually, this plot is, in this plot, you are living only one person. But this plot is part of this building. This is virtual private server. Another one is dedicated server. Dedicated server means you are living in independent house. Independent house means first we are purchasing this land, after we are registering and we are taking permission from municipality, after we are constructing one building, after we are living here, that time we are paying some money to municipal corporation, water bill, electricity bill, everything we are maintaining here. Means this is the independent house. Independent house. Means this is a shared room. Means different persons sharing one room. This is the plot. Means virtual private server. Means here we are hiring some part of that server. But here we are maintaining one own server. Means total house is belongs to ours. So independent house means first we are hiring. Independent house means first we are purchasing land, after the constructing building, after we are paying every month some money to municipal corporation, water bill, electricity, everything here. Means maintenance and expenses is the independent house here. So compared to this three, this is a very cheaper. But in this have some drawback. Means here in shared hosting, accessible means accessing website is very slow. And in this shared hosting, if other website have any virus, then the virus infected your websites also. And this is a virtual private server. Virtual private server means here service provider is maintaining one very big server. In this big server, we are hiring some part for our web hosting purpose. So that time compared to this, this is a faster and it is also expensive compared to this one. Another one is the independent house. Independent house means it is a dedicated server. Dedicated server means this server only specially for your website purpose. So it is very costly, very, very costly compared to these two. And another one is cloud hosting. In this cloud hosting, in the place of one server, we are using many computers. We are using many computers and we are creating one cloud in network and we are uploading our web pages. So in this, now we are uploading our web pages and that time this all computers is connected and create one network, create one cloud in network. And now I am uploading my files. Now it is providing service to us. For example, suddenly in this any computer is or any server is down. Any server is down, immediately this load is taken by another server. This is the main advantage in this one. Means, for example, this server is down, unfortunately. Immediately, this total load is automatically taken by another server. Here, don't think why I am saying server and why I am saying computer. Server is nothing but a computer. In previous classes, we are discussing supercomputer and mainframe computer and mini computer, personal computer. Here, server also one type of computer. Don't think server is different, personal computer is different. As per performance, server is high performance computer and our personal computer is very low performance computer. So here, you also say this is server. And you say this is server, this is server, this is server, this is server. All are servers. Now, all servers is connecting in cloud and in network. Now I am uploading my web files in this cloud. So here, if any means, if in this any server is down, immediately the total load is taken by another server. And in this another advantage is, for example, this only one server. In this we are uploading some web files. Simple example, if secondary school means 10th class result is coming, that immediately every student is try to access that intermediate board server. If number of hits is coming, that time the server is slow, sometimes the server is down. Means here, for example, that's inter that 10th class board or SSC board or secondary school board maintaining only one server. So if 10th class result is coming, every student has exiting. What is my result? How many marks I am getting? Immediately every person is try to access this server. If number of hits is increasing, that time the server is slow, very slow. Sometimes server also down. So if you are using one single PC, single computer, single server, if number of hits is increasing, immediately server is slow or server is down. That is the drawback. But in this, in cloud hosting, in this advantage is, if number of hits is increasing, that time the total load is balanced by other servers. That is the main advantage of this cloud hosting. If you are upload our web files in cloud hosting, that time if number of hits is increasing, that time the total load is balanced by other servers. That is the advantage. Another advantage is, if suddenly if any server is down, that total that load balance is automatically taken by another server. This is the another advantage. And compared to what is that dedicated server, this is a cheaper cost and more efficient. Means in this server side issues very less. And in this another advantage is, if you want to upgrade your server, cloud server, means if you want increasing your RAM and if you want increase your processor speed or if you want increasing your hard disk, it is possible in cloud computing without shutdown. Means here, if you want upgrade your RAM, if you want upgrade your processor, it is possible in cloud hosting. This is also one main advantage of in cloud hosting. Now here, web server. Web server means nothing but one computer. But server purpose we are using high speed computer. And here one doubt. Here, for example, first what we are discussing, shared hosting. What is the meaning of hosting? Every time you are repeating this part, hosting, hosting, hosting. What is the meaning of hosting? Hosting means, as per our theory, one machine, one computer connected with another computer by using internet, it is called hosting. Means here this computer is called as server and this computer is called as a client. One server is connected to client through internet, it is called hosting. Means hosting means this server communicating to this client PC by using this internet, that is called hosting. This is the theoretically definition of hosting. And now we are uploading our web pages in server. Actually, this web pages is two types: static web pages, and another one is the dynamic. Yes. So static web pages means in this we cannot change anything in this. Dynamic web pages means, for example, if anyone means you are uploading your website by using dynamic. You are uploading your website with a dynamic mode. That time, if any client accessing your website, immediately is giving message to you. One client, that person, strange person accessing your website. That type of feature is available in dynamic. Simple example means dynamic website. Means dynamic websites means Facebook.
Sir, you have 10 minutes more. You have 10 minutes more.
I am completing 1 or 2 minutes.
Okay.
This dynamic web pages. Dynamic web pages. Simple example is Facebook. Another one is Twitter. Means these two websites is using dynamic web pages. Means if anyone is accessing this websites, immediately this information passed to that owner of this Facebook. Means here anyone accessing, imagine that information passes to owner of this Facebook. Means here these are the main advantage of dynamic. For example, I am running my shop. One person is accessing my website and the person is checking some TV or some cooler price list. So immediately that information is coming to my website owner, means admin. Immediately my admin is send one message to that client PC. Sir, you are accessing my website and you are checking price list. If you visit my shop, I am trying to reduce that equipment cost. Please visit to my shop. Means this is a very advantage of this website owner. Means how many clients daily accessing my website, which type of items they are watching, and they are checking price list, and which content they are accessing. Every information is available in dynamic web. This is the main advantage of this dynamic web pages. Static web pages means in this type of information is not available in static web pages. Only dynamic web pages have this type of facility. This facility purpose, we are using one special language, special programs. Means in this we are using PHP and Python. We are using this programming, this software, and we are creating this dynamic web pages. Dynamic web pages in terms, we are using external language, PHP and Python. Any doubts in this?